I'm Dr. Tom Booth, and I work at the Natural History Museum in London, and I work on a project where we're extracting DNA out of ancient skeletons in order to look at their ancestry, to see when you get big changes in ancestry in the people living in Britain.
It's looking at the patterns in the ancient DNA when you get big changes in the ancient DNA, and seeing whether that's related or can be related at all to any of the changes in lifestyle and changes in culture that you get at different periods.
When people think about migration and mobility in Britain and British populations, they tend to think about the migrations that occur in the first millennium AD, so these as Saxons, Romans, Normans. But it's always assumed that before this point that there aren't many big changes, but the analysis of ancient DNA is changing that idea. So after the glaciers retreat, you have people moving back into Britain from southern Spain, but around 14,000 years ago, you get a new movement of people that originated originally in the Near East, but moved across Europe into Britain, and they mostly replaced this population that came into Britain originally from Spain. Similarly, around 6,000 years ago, the population has been changed again, so these people ultimately derive from somewhere in Anatolia or around the Aegean and have moved across Europe with farming practices and end up in Britain. And then once more, around 4,500 years ago, you get a migration into Britain that originates from Russia around the Black Sea, which inevitably bring with them metalworking. So each one of these prehistoric migrations brings new physical traits, new innovations and new technologies. We see shifts from darker skin to lighter skin, from brown eyes to blue eyes, from dark hair to light hair, and seeing blonde hair for the first time. You get the establishment of these large-scale networks, trading networks across Europe, where people are trading in metals, pottery and other precious objects for the first time. And through these networks, you get the establishment of more sophisticated cultures and more complex cultural practices. So from around 3,000 years ago, from the beginning of the Iron Age, we don't get as many big changes in the genetics of people living in Britain, but what we do seem to get is, again, the constant flow of people in and out of Britain from other parts of Europe. So the impression that you get is, rather than being this kind of static prehistoric Britain, it's this dynamic mobile place where people are constantly moving in and out, exchanging ideas, bringing new ideas and bringing new ancestries which we can pick up using this technology. So the prehistory and history of Britain is inextricably linked to the history of Europe.